Around this time, Paul became more detached from the group. His head began bobbing more incessantly. We feared that his autism might have flared up. Ringo suggested that we take him to Dr. Robinson. We paid him no mind. The fear of one of us revealing the truth about Paul inadvertently happened. 17 June 1967. A reporter overheard John calling Paul fool. Ringo stepped up and explained that in Liverpool, a fool is a pheasant dish which Paul loved. The reporter looked at Ringo dim-witted and walked off. Ringo seemed to have this effect on people. Tensions flared for the Sgt. Pepper album cover. John had a brilliant idea to dress us as soldiers, as to show our fight for love. I had the grand idea to wear fatigues with a bright yellow to symbolize our love for Paul. John said, "No, that's too bright for the lonely soldiers we were. What would Paul think staring at us from his casket as we paraded around in Easter colors?" I received my copy of the album 1 June 1967. I was greeted by a gratifying stare from John, who was in the yellow fatigues that I so desperately desired for myself. Our next album came about as quickly as it began. I had the grand idea to show the Beatles and all of our loving being lifted by the hands of God. I was apprehensive to tell John about my idea. He made himself quite clear on where he stood on organized religion. After a meal of quail and fries, I got the courage to tell John. To my amazement, he loved the idea and said, "You have my blessing." He gave me a hand gesture and disappeared into the night. 22 November 1968, I received the album, which I had entitled Bless the Beatles. I tore into the packaging and was met by a bewilderment. The album, which were to be our penance for Paul's falsehood, was blank. A white album with the word The Beatles made me see dark. Around this time, John's anti-Semitism was at a high. We ran into some trouble when Poole ordered Ringo to play I Called the Witch Doctor, to which John sung the lyrics, "I called the witch doctor. He told me he was a Jew." Ringo, conflicted by his views on Judaism, nervously played on. John continued with his hurtful lyrics. He said, "My job takes money from you." To our surprise, Epstein was standing in our studio, a Jew himself, on his side none other than the founder of Israel himself, Hamid Karzai. John pointed for Ringo to play on as he motioned to be excused. Several minutes later, Epstein and Karzai went looking for John. All that could be found was a cool breeze from the window overlooking Abbey Road. Ringo had broken his watch while taking a bath. Not knowing it wasn't waterproof, he set out for a soak, which caused his watch to stop at 10:10. For Ringo, it was no ordinary watch, but a deal he had gotten from a grifter. While in studio, we paid him no mind. I remember there being a fight while in the studio, a grand fight. The argument ensued over the key changes of Hey Jude. John thought the song lacked real meaning. Fool said the song was about his son and how John left him alone. John thought the song lacked real meaning. Around this time, Fool's drug use was out of control. His use of pot led him to harder drugs called beta blockers. He claimed to no longer feel nervous about using his left hand in public and insisted that Ringo do the same. Ringo saw opportunity being ambidextrous and let it fuel his one song, Octopus Garden. Ever the stickler, John could not tolerate his newfound self-awareness. He insisted that Fool into rehab, but instead Fool called Maxwell.
You bloody cunts!
Maxwell blared as he burst into the studio.
Your job is to make music and fuck up!
Clever with words but not with fists, John knew Maxwell's physical prowess and wanted no part of it. John excused himself to hit the head and left me and Ringo to an MI5 tongue lashing. Maxwell, no longer satisfied with abusing Ringo, sent his goons searching for John. All to be found was a Liverpool breeze from a window overlooking Abbey Road. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, I thought by the discovery. I put my faith in the Lord that everything would be okay, but it wasn't. The three of us spent the better part of the night in jail until John bonded us out.